as you call them. I'm a designer maker and a creative director at Stitchville Limited. I will show you a range of knitting techniques.
In this video tutorial, I will show you how to make a knitted flower. You will need a set of double pointed needles, 3 markers, tapestry needle, and a yarn cutter. To see how to cast on your stitches onto double pointed needles and how to work first couple of rows, please refer to the video tutorial on how to knit on double pointed needles. Now that we have gotten to this point, we have a cast on row here and 2 knit rows. We are going to place markers in our next round. So I'm going to knit around. I have 10 stitches on every needle and I'm going to place a marker right in the middle of every needle. So I'm making sure that my join between the needles is nice and tight. I'm going to knit 5 stitches and place a mark on my needle, and then I will knit remaining 5 stitches. In the next round I will start decreasing. Now the decrease sequence is as follows. I will knit 3 stitches, or in other words, I will knit 2 stitches before the marker. I will then knit those 2 stitches together. So I'm going into the front of 2 stitches at the same time, and I'm knitting out of them as usual. I will need to slip my marker then and knit 2 last 2 stitches on this needle. I will then repeat the sequence on 2 remaining needles. I have now finished the round, and in this round I have decreased 6 stitches. The next round is going to be plain round. I now have 24 stitches. The following round will be our decrease round. So again, I will knit 2 stitches before the marker, and then I will knit those 2 stitches together. I will slip my marker and knit 2 last 2 stitches on this needle. I will then knit them together. I will repeat this sequence on 2 remaining needles. Now we're ready to finish our flower. To do so, I will cut my thread. I will allow a little bit of extra length just in case you want to attach the flower to something. I will go around, taking the stitches off the needle and transferring them onto the tapestry needle, one by one. It's a good idea to actually secure the yarn, which I will do by making a little slip knot, which I will anchor on one of the stitches. And that's how you make a knitted flower.